This is three ways that I love using shape masks in Final Cut Pro. The first way that I love using shape masks is for color isolation. If we just select our clip here, we can push Command 6 and that will get us our colors here, or you can drag it over from the effects browser. And I'm going to add the color wheels as I typically do. And if we come up to this icon right here, we can click that and you can see we can add a shape mask or a color mask. Today, I'm going to first actually add a color mask. And if you click and drag, you can broaden your selection. You can see everything that it's selecting there. If you're not totally happy with that, you can actually push shift. You'll see that plus symbol on my dropper. And I can even increase the selection a little bit more and get those darker areas. So now that we have our color selection applied, we can go to the outside and we can just drop the saturation globally. So now you will see that only the red areas have any saturation to them. Now, if we want to further this isolation, we can actually come up here, click this icon once again and add a shape mask, and we can just circle it right around the rows that we want to be affected. You could also come over here, add a keyframe, move along a bit, and animate that keyframe so that your mask just stays on your rows. The next way that I love using shape masks is for applying effects to certain areas. So normally for a scene like this, let's say that I want the outside edge to look like we're almost looking through a TV or something. So I'm just gonna come down to my effects panel, search up bad TV, and we'll apply that onto our effect. Now normally the effect is applied to the entire clip. So to fix that, we'll come over to our video panel. We will click this icon and we will add a shape mask, and we can click and drag it so that our shape mask comes out to the edges and we can actually feather it here. But the problem is that now the effect is only applying in the center. So to fix this, all we're gonna do is come up to our shape masks here and invert the mask. And we now have a vignetted bad TV effect just happening to the outer edges. So you can do this with any effect that you like. And you could even add more shape masks. Let's see, we'll add one more. And let's say we want this to be a subtract mask. So we could actually have the mask applying and we've got now a bad TV donut. The third and final way that I love using shape masks is to sharpen specific parts of an image. So I have this shot of my wife. She was very gracious to let me film her. So thank you, wife. You'll notice I filmed purposefully so that her eye is a little bit soft in focus. So what we'll do, we'll look up the sharpen filter here. Now, if you have something like Color Finale or something like that, I strongly suggest you use that sharpener instead. It's just a little bit better than the one built into Final Cut. But today we will use the basic sharpener. So we'll just drag it up, make things looking nice and sharp. But if I drag this way up, you can see how it like really messes with her skin. So we're gonna sharpen it just to where we're happy with how our eye is. We'll click at our shape mask and put that over the top of her eye. And we can bring down the feathering just a little bit. And then we can add keyframes and push shift right arrow and just move it along with her eye to track on the mask here. So we now have this tracked on sharpening and her eye looks nice and in focus. If that was helpful, you might want to consider checking out this video, which shows you how to use shape masks to whiten teeth in Final Cut Pro. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.